Today's problem is based on a historic incident. Once, 41 Jewish soldiers, including Josephus, were trapped in a cave by Roman soldiers. They chose suicide over capture, so they sat in a circle and decided that starting from a particular position, a person would kill the next adjacent person, then the next living person would kill the next adjacent living person, and pattern would continue. Last alive person would have two options, either suicide or surrender. For example, person on position 1 kills person on position 2, then 3 kills 4, then 5 kills 6. After 13, there is no 14, so 13 kills 1, 3 kills 5, and so on. Josephus wanted to be the last alive person and wanted to surrender instead of suicide. At what position he should sit if there were n soldiers? This problem is known as Josephus problem, named after Flavius Josephus. You are watching Brain Explorers, the world where brain starts working. Solution in the video contains three parts, which can be treated as different approaches to solve the problem. First, using recurrence formula, second, by general formula, and third, using binary numbers. Suppose fn is the last alive person when there are n persons. Fn is the function of n, which is the answer of this problem for different values of n. Add n new persons in the circle. Between every two persons who are already in the circle, one new person is seated. After this event, original positions of persons are changed. You can see that person who was on second position is now on the third position. Third one is on the fifth position. Fourth one is on the seventh position. To find the new position, multiply the previous position by 2 and subtract 1. So the final remaining position is shifted to 2 times fn minus 1. This time, total number of people are 2n. Now, start the same procedure. All the newly added persons are killed before the previous persons. So, after one cycle, problem is reduced to previous situation except the positions of person. This time, the last alive person is 2fn minus 1 because this is the corresponding position of last alive person. From this mathematical model, a recurrence formula is obtained. F21 is equal to 2fn minus 1. From this, we can calculate the solution for 2n if we know the solution for n. For example, F20 is equal to 2f10 minus 1 and f10 is equal to 2f5 minus 1. 5 is an odd number, therefore it cannot be calculated with this formula. It works only for even numbers. But with a slight variation in our logical model of the problem, we can find a recurrence formula which can be used for odd numbers. This time, consider one extra person between 1 and 2, as well as assume that the respective position is first. So the person who was originally on the first position is now on 2n plus 1th position because of n plus 1 extra persons. Positions of all other people are changed in the same manner as in the previous model. New positions are 2 times previous position minus 1. Here also, all the new persons are killed before the previous persons. New cancellation cycle starts from one successive place in comparison to the previous cycle. So, the last remaining number also belongs to one successive place in comparison to the previous one. Position corresponding to the position next to fn is 2 times fn plus 1. Recurrence formula obtained here is f2n plus 1 equals to 2fn plus 1. Using formula for both even and odd, let's calculate the value of f13. It can be written as 2f6 plus 1. f6 can be written as 2f3 minus 1. f3 can be written as 2f1 plus 1, and value of f1 is 1. We get f13 equals to 11. You can check it by writing natural numbers from 1 to 13 and cancelling alternate numbers. Here comes the second and easier way to solve the problem. Here, value of fn for first 16 numbers is given. Pause the video and try to figure out the general rule for this sequence. Ready? Value of fn is 1 when n is equal to some power of 2. For example, 32 is 5th power of 2. Thus, f32 is equal to 1. After 1, until next one occurs in the sequence, sequence behaves as arithmetic progression with a common difference of 2. Let f of mth power of 2 is equal to 1. So f of 2 raised to the power m plus 1 is 1 plus 2. Next two numbers of the sequence are 1 plus 2 times 2 and 1 plus 2 times 3. Let's calculate f263. 263 lies between 2 to the power 8 and 2 to the power 9. Subtract 2 to the power 8 from 263. We get 7. So it can be written as 256 plus 7. So f263 is equal to 1 plus 2 times 7. In general, we can write fn equals to 1 plus 2 times n minus 2 to the power bracket log n at the base 2, where bracket is greatest integer function or integral part. This procedure looks quite simple when performed with binary numbers. First of all, convert the number into binary number. Then, take the leftmost one and put it to the rightmost place. We get the solution in binary. Now, convert it again into decimal. There is a problem for you. If instead of alternate places, persons are eliminated after every two places, then how to find the last remaining person? Its solution will be discussed in the next part of this upload. Don't forget to like and share our video, and for more such videos, subscribe to our channel Brain Explorers. Thanks for watching.